So welcome students. In this session we are going to do hands-on on whatever we have discussed in previous lecture. So when we are discussing introduction to pointer, so in that we have discussed idea of pointer and how we define a pointer. So with help of this hands-on we are going to understand idea of pointer and how we are going to define a pointer. So for this, first of all let us declare a integer variable x, which we all familiar with how we declare a variable of a particular type. So now I am going to print address of the address of the value x. So address of the variable x. So for this I have to write value of x is equal to %d and address of x is equal to %u. As we have seen that for address we need format specifier %u. So for value we need to write x directly, and for address we need to add % to u. So with help of % we can actually get address of the variable x. So now we are going to run it in order to see what is going to happen. So I am going to modify it int main, and here we are going to return 0. So now we are going to run it. So value of x is equal to 0 and address of x is equal to 6487580. So this is the value of x because we have burnt x is equal to 0, so by default it is initialized at 0, and address of x is equal to 6487580. So we will initialize it and then we will see what is going to happen. So you will see that value of x will become 5 and address of x is, I think it is similar, so it may vary from one compile to another compile that how this address is going to be printed. How the memory is allocated, for example at different compilation time maybe another memory location will be allocated, so this address may change. So as we have discussed, a variable has its name x, a value which is 5, what we have given to it, what we have initialized, and the address is the memory location which on which the value is stored, which is allocated by the compiler when we compile our program. So this is the address of the variable x, and this is the value of the variable x. So here we have seen that how we are going to find address of a variable x. So from this we get idea of pointer. So can we store %x? Can we store address of a variable in some other variable? So if we want to change, for example, if we want to deal with address of a variable, so can we do it? Yes, we can do it by, as we have discussed, we can declare a pointer variable p. So here we have declared a pointer variable p, which is, so what does it mean? P is a pointer variable, so it will decay, it will point to a variable of integer type. So P will point a variable to a variable of integer type. So now we will initialize the pointer. So pointer is basically a variable. Pointer is basically a variable which stores the address of another variable. So P, we are going to initialize it with address of x. So we have initialized P is equal to address of x. So we are going to value of t, because it is, it basically it is a address. So value of t is equal to percent u, and address of p is equal to also percent u, because t is the value of p will be address of x, and the address of p will be some other address. So we have written that value of p is equal to percent u, and value of p and address of p is equal to percent u. So now we are going to run this and see. So we have omitted the backslash, that's why we are getting some jumbled result. So make it clear, and now we are going to run it. So you will see, what we will see, that value of x is equal to 5 and address of x is equal to 5, and again this is printed, and value of p is equal to, so you will see, you can clearly see that the value of p and address of x is exactly same. So 6487580 and 6487580, so those are basically same. So you can easily connect that the value of p is, what is the value of p? It is same as address of x. So address of x is stored in here. We have stored address of x in p. So that's why p is, the value of p is of address type, and what is it? It is exactly address of x. And what is the address of p? It is some other address, 6487568. So this is another address. So how we are going to find value of x with help of p? So here we can see that we have to print value of x. So it will depend on what type of value we are going to print. So according to that, we have to put here format specifier. For example, we want to print value of x, but with help of pointer. So for this, we need to add asterisk symbol, so which is in direction operator. So it will give the value stored at location pointed by p. So p is pointing to variable x. So in p, the address of x is there, we have already seen. So we have used asterisk symbol in order to get the value stored at this location, and for address we can directly use p. So now we are going to, so as we can see that with help of this, we with help of this command, we have find the value of x, which is percent %5, and address of x is 6487580, and value of p, which is actually address of x, and address of p is something similarly we can also find value of x using, because we have initialized p as address of x. So okay, with help of address of x we can use a pointer to find value of x. So value of x is equal to percent %, and what will be value of x? It is basically asterisk p, which signifies that which asterisk is an indirection operator. So value at the address pointed by p. So and address of x will be p. So address of x will be p, because p contains address of. So let us match it with output, that value of x is equal to 5, address is equal to 6487580, value of p 60, exactly same as address of x, and value of x is equal to 5. So here we have used x to get value of x, and here we have used asterisk p to get the value of p, and we are getting same result. And for address of x, we can directly use p, because p is a pointer variable which we have initialized with address of x. So p is basically pointing to, p is stored at 6487568 and its value is 6487580, and this value is actually pointing to the variable x because it contains address of x. And what is the value at this location? Value at this location is 5. So we can find value of x with in this manner by using a pointer variable. So hope this is clear. So now we are going to discuss that how we are going to add or subtract with help of pointer. So we can actually, for example, value at, we can use value at p is equal to value at p plus 5. Value at p is equal to value at p plus 5. Value of x is equal to percent t, and again we are value of x is equal to percent d. So we are writing in this way. So what do we get? So what do we get? So here we have already discussed, but with help of value at p is equal to value at p plus 5. So what will the new value of x? X is equal to 10, but this x is printed by this with help of indirection operator, and this value of, so is printed with help of x directly name of variable. So you can see that both the values are actually same. So either way you can print the value of x. You can directly use its name, or you can also use a pointer variable. So with help of a pointer variable and indirection operator, you can print or you can use the use a variable. So with help of a pointer we can also access a variable. So so now what I have done, that we are printing, we are printing value of p and we are printing value of p plus 1. That with help of this we are going to discuss what we have studied in tomorrow's class, that when we increment a pointer, then what happens. So you can see that when we have printed value of p to 6487580 and value of p plus 1 is equal to 6487584. So you can see that here, when we increment p by 1, when we add 1 in p, so it will incremented by 4 because the size of integer is 4. So actually p is pointing to some integer variable. So size of integer in this compiler is 4 bytes. So the scaling factor is 4. So size will be 4. So when we use p plus 1, then it is it is incremented by 4. So similarly, we can do it for example, I'm going to character and going to use p1. So p1, I am going to and a, and a is equal to s. So I have declared here a character variable a and initialize it with s, and declared a character pointer p1 and initialize it with a with address of a. So yeah, or we can just do it here. Control X. P1 is equal to, and in P1 we are going to store address of character variable A. So value of A will be %C because character type, and what we are going to P1, and here we are going to %C that we are going to print by both ways, and value of P1 is equal to %U, and value of P plus 1 is equal to %U, and here we are going to use P1 because we are taking P1 as address of character variable A. So now we are going to we have omitted P1 here, so that's why it is first showing error. So P1 is equal to %A. So we have made some mistake. So we have made some mistakes, that's why it is showing. So now it is okay. So we can see. So we have initialized character A as S, and we have declared a character pointer P1. So in P1 we are storing address of A. So we are going to print value of A by both ways. So you can see that if we point a, if we are printing it by using indirection operator and with help of character pointer p1, so you can see value of a is equal to s and value of a is equal to s. We have and value of a is equal to s. So by both ways we can print, and similarly if we increment, so if increment a character pointer by 1, then what will be result? So here you can see that 64, 87, 559 and 64, 560. So it will be increased by only 1 because size of character is 1 byte. but in case of integer, size of integer is 4 byte. That's why if we increase or add 1 to a integer pointer, then it will be increased by 4. So 522 to it becomes 526. But in case of character variable, the character pointer will increase by 1 because the size of character is only 1. So basically it will point to, when we increase it by 1, so it will point to next integer variable. So an integer value which may be there. So it will when we use pointer with arrays, then we will going to use this addition of a constant value to pointer and subtraction of constant value to pointer. So hope this hands-on tutorial is clear to you, and so thank you for listening. And in case of any query, you can ask, and you can do it for other type of variable. Integer character I have done, so you can do it with float type of variable. This is your homework. So if you have any query, then you can ask me. And thank you for listening.